Hello, 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 and welcome to Why You Should Watch Buster Scruggs. But before we get into that, I want to first mention that I'm doing a subscriber goal, and I'm trying to reach 10 subscribers by the end of January, and if we reach that, I'm going to have a gift card giveaway. One person's going to win probably $10, maybe $20. And all you have to do to enter is comment down below something you want me to draw in MS Paint, and I can put it up in the next video I have it available. A beginning and do a shout out or something. Just a fun way to say thank you. And if you don't want anything, just write I subscribe or something like that. Just letting me know and I'll enter you in. And one last thing before we get to the video. The channel direction. The Agretzigo video blew every video I've ever done out of the water. Like, most of them combined would not have as many views or watch time, I don't think. I haven't run the numbers. But I'm not going to change it to a compilation channel. That's not something I want to do. But I am going to take it as a sign that I should be more fluid with what I do. I enjoy making different, unique content, and I'm just going to do that from now on. Whatever I think of that I think will be a good video, I'm just going to do that. So without further ado, let's get to this video, which is going to be a series, maybe, where I review a movie. Not really review, more recommend. And this one's Buster Scruggs, or The Ballad of Buster Scruggs, and is a Coen Brothers film. If you don't know who they're incredible at making movies. And it's on Netflix, if you want to watch it there, and I'm sure it's available in DVD elsewhere. And the reason I would recommend this film is because it has something for everyone. No matter what your taste, it's got something for you. Now, the movie is made up of six small movies, with the only thing connecting them being that they're set in the Old West. And they range drastically. The first one being an absurd comedy, like, really silly, ridiculous, yet, at the same time, it's got a few grounded moments, and I don't want to reveal too much of it. You really should just go in this as blind as possible, but I think you should talk briefly about what you're getting into. Because it's, while it has something for everyone combined, I'd say it's not for everyone, but I think it's definitely a great film. And personally, it is my favorite one. The first one is. The second one is also a comedy. It has one absurd scene, but for the most part, it's generally low-key. It's not as outright outrageous as the previous one. And then the movie transitions drastically for the third film. When you first watch, this is my probably only criticism about the film, is how they compiled and what order they did. Because if you watch this blind, you'll watch the first two and think this is a comedy movie. And it's a bunch of comedies, but it is not. And the rest of them are not comedies. And third one is extremely dark. And I don't mean dark as in like a black comedy. It's more of a just a very dark film. I wasn't a big fan of it. It's probably my least favorite of the six. But it does have a story to tell, and the acting's amazing. The scenery and setting's beautiful. It's really well made. And the fourth film is a drama. Almost feels kind of like a documentary. Of a prospector and him mining for gold. And he's got the pan and he's counting the specks of gold, and then he finds more or less and zones in on the area and starts digging and stuff. It's definitely a slower paced one. It has a lot of silence. Beautiful scenery. It's absolutely breathtaking scenery. I don't know where it was filmed, but it's beautiful. And that just, it's the tonal shifts. It's very different, all of them are very different, but extremely well made and just great to watch. Now, the fifth film is the most mainstream of the Westerns. Now, the others were unique, interesting takes on a Western film, whether it goes in a comedic direction or a dark direction or in a kind of documentary kind of direction. But in this one, it's what you would expect if you went into the theaters today and just saw a Western. Like, there's no, like, interesting take on it. It's just a very well-made film. It is probably my second favorite or third. Definitely up in the... Then you get to the last film. And after this roller coaster of emotions you've been on for the past 2 hours, you're ready for anything. Except for this one. Most of it takes place in a stagecoach as they're riding along with these 5 passengers, and they're just talking for most of the trip. And there's a shift halfway through, and it changes into an allegory. And yeah, it's something you just have to see for yourself. Now I'm going to play you a short clip from the first one, The Ballad of Buster Scruggs. I was kind of hoping this would be the whole film, and I'm kind of sad that it wasn't. But the other films did have some interesting takes, so not too upset, but I would like to see a film like this come out as a separate thing, because I really love this character, and you'll probably love him too as soon as you watch. Thank you for watching.
Come out.
Well, this is well timed. You gentlemen mind if I take his spot?
If and you play his hand.
I would prefer not to.
It is too late. You have regarded the cards.
You seen him, you play him.
I ain't any.
The other hombre aren't it.
You seen him, you play him.
And if and I don't?
You play them cards, fancy Dan.
Can't no one compel another man to engage in recreation. Certainly not a son of a gun as ill-humored as yourself. And as for names, my horse is Dan. I'm Buster. Buster Scruggs.
Buster Scruggs? The run from Riata Pass? And this pistol?
I do hail from Riata Pass, which is in the county of San Saba. Being the which of why the San Saba Songbird is my sobriquet of preference. But right now, I'd appreciate it if you'd deposit your weapon in the receptacle by the swinging doors, which concealing of it on your person in the first place was a violation of the rules of this establishment and an offense against local norms.
And if and I don't?